My name is Erica Smith. I have three children at the school. I have Ella, who's in year seven, and I have Grace in year five, and Tom in year one.
I have two. I have a daughter and a son. They're both now just in high school. My daughter started in year three, and my son wasn't young enough to start school then, so my son's been from kindy all the way. He's just started in the year seven centre now.
I'm Emma Reynolds, and my children at Grandma are Cooper in year eight and Rosie in year five.
My name is Christine Hill, and I've had three children come to the school, and I have two left here. And I was a graduating student from 91, and I boarded here from year eight through to year 12.
I think we all want our children to be allowed and enabled to reach their potential. My children have quite diverse interests and abilities, and they, you know, in terms of opportunities for sport, for drama, for music, for academic opportunities.
The opportunities that Grandma was able to provide for my children who had specific academic need, particularly extension. And so I suppose Grandma was a school that was geared to be able to cater to their needs. And since they've come to the school, I've realised how many more opportunities were actually available than I sort of first thought. So in the drama and music fields particularly. So basically for all the opportunities that are here. What I love about the school is that they value every individual for their ability. So no matter what your child is good at, and it doesn't have to be academic, it doesn't have to be sport, but whatever your child's gift is, or even if they haven't kind of found what their gift is, they've got that ability to shine somewhere along the line. So I think that they value each child on their own merit, and they're happy to celebrate successes of kids, whereas I find other schools like to sort of sometimes play down individual kids' successes, whereas here they really celebrate all kids and their successes, which I think is really fantastic.
It's like everybody wants to do really well. Everybody wants to be really, you know, it's okay to be really smart, or it's okay to be really good at athletics or really good at sport or in the arts. It's, you know, it's okay to be really, really good at stuff. And I think that's a really good part of the school as well.
The teachers, you can tell, because I'm from a teaching background, that the teachers talk a lot and they share a lot of ideas. There's a lot of sort of cross-pollination between different subject areas, and the way they're able to sort of all coordinate, I don't know how they fit everything in the day that they do, but the way they're able to like collaborate and do this fantastic project-based learning, open-ended activity, so kids can, build structures of the Eiffel Tower and all these fantastic things. So it's extremely encouraging learning environment. It's collaborative, and the sky's the limit really as far as what the kids want to do.
I think a lot of people, when they think of school, they think just about doing well in maths and English and science maybe, and being top of the class. But I think the children seem to progress at different ages, and they excel at different things at different times. So I think they seem to work with each child at their own pace. The camp program gives them a completely different experience of being not just in the classroom, but outside. They can experience differences. They see their teachers in a different light. They see their friends in a different light. Some kids find it really challenging. Sometimes the one who are very comfortable in the classroom situation then find, you know, it's very different in camp.
One thing that really impresses me about Grandma is the communication. So there's never have to guess about anything. I love that it's always electronically done. There's no lost piece of paper at the bottom of the school bag where you don't find out about anything. So there's always plenty of opportunity to meet with teachers or administration if you've got problems or want to clarify something. But usually it's extremely streamlined and smooth. I find that it's very easy. They're very quick to respond to your inquiries or questions.
There's the after school curriculum. There's a wide variety, not just from sport, but music, art. And they encourage all the kids to have a go. They don't force them, but they encourage them, which is really nice. And sometimes they try things which they didn't think they would and find, oh, I really like that. That was really good. And so, it's the broad spectrum of things, really, from drama, arts, music, through to sport and academic stuff as well. So, yeah, it's about them finding themselves and what they like and what they're good at.
Thinking beyond their little zone of life is really important to become rounded citizens, and given the opportunity to give back. Both of my girls coach junior sport teams. So at the moment they're coaching the little kindy to grade twos in hockey, which is just a really nice opportunity to give back to the school, and I love that that's encouraged.
And I was very keen for my kids to keep their broad-minded approach. And I do find that's wonderful here at the school, even though they say they're an Anglican faith school. When I read through the brochure, I was actually thinking, oh my goodness, because that sounded so different. But I find it's actually lovely because they treat the kids to be kind and they're inclusive of all faiths. You know, we've been made to feel really welcome. I really do like the side that they have a kind of spiritual side to the kids as well. I think they don't force them, it just helps them to question the world around them. So it's been really, really good just to like open up their minds to different cultures and different things. So the school's really encouraging that way, that there's more to the, you know, they've fully appreciated this beautiful surrounds we have here in WA, but there's a whole different world out there. And then the Round Square projects, I think, is great how they encourage like a more international outlook in life as well through the Round Square project. That's really good.
The fact that I just love coming to school and they, you know, they get up each day enthusiastic to come is a good enough sign for me that they're, you know, being well looked after while they're here.
On her very first day when she started in year three, I think I was more nervous then than when she first ever started school, but because she wasn't a very confident child and I was worried that the big move would knock her confidence. And she came out having had the most fantastic day and she's always loved it. So that was me in itself, the fact that she happily came to school and she was happy here.
I think what we all want most of all is for them to be happy, right? You know, you want them to have opportunities and do well and all of that, but that all comes secondary to being happy. And I think if I can send my kids to school every day and then be happy to go with a smile on their face, then everything else is a bonus.
I just think it's a really lovely environment and it is like a big family.
Bunbury Cathedral Grammar School.
Every opportunity!